Let's remove our previous static stuff from XAML. Now go to your click event. It's time to allow creating multiple lines at once. When the button is clicked, we will first check the value in the text box. The program will draw only if there is a number. Create a random class instance for random drawing. Now, if the value is not a number, it will be red. Otherwise, we will restore the default background color of the text box. Next, create a for loop, which will execute as many times as it is written in the text box. Place your code for creating a line in the loop. Now, let's think. It's quite easy to draw random lines anywhere. But if they are not connected, it will look like a mess. So, to connect lines, we need to store every line in a collection, specifically in a list of lines. The list should be defined in the class. Now, before we set the coordinates, we will check if the list of lines is empty, which means that the program is drawing the first line. If the count of lines is zero, the program will draw a line anywhere in the window. Anywhere means randomness, of course. For x coordinates, use actual width. Use actual height for y coordinates. Alternatively, if there is already a line in the window, we will continue drawing from it. X1 of a new line will be identical to X2 of the previous line. X2 of a new line will be random again. Repeat the same for the Y coordinate. After the line is created, add it to the list of lines. A very important step. Change my grid to canvas so that your lines do not go over the controls panel. Don't forget to set a name for your canvas control. And finally, tell the program what to do if the user writes text on nothing instead of a number in the text box. I will make the background tomato. Let's check what we have made. We have tomato color in the text box if the value is not valid. But if it is a number, the program will draw a line. If we keep clicking, the lines are created starting from the previous coordinates. It acts the same way if we draw multiple lines at once. And look what happens if we resize the window. Our workspace grows bigger. The basics are finished here. Congratulations! Now let's add more editing tools. What if I need to delete the previous line? For example, I have managed to get a good logo picture, but the last piece made it worse. Though I like all the other lines, so I don't want to clear everything, only that one line. And another case. What if the picture is just bad? Do I have to restart the program? I think it is better to have two separate buttons for deleting the previous line and deleting all lines. In your button for deleting the previous line, first check if there are any lines to avoid an exception. Then remove the last line from the list and from the canvas. In your button for clearing the canvas, clear the list and canvas. When you click Delete Previous, it always deletes the previous line. It's like undo in Paint, but with almost unlimited memory. The Clear button works just fine. Now, look what happens when we have hundreds and thousands of lines. The process memory gets filled. When you clear the list and the canvas, it is restored, but not completely. So I don't recommend drawing 10,000 lines at once. You may think we are done, but we aren't. Have you seen the title? Also, let's make the window appear in the center of the screen. Another little tweak. Set the text of textbox to be a number in XAML. Soon we will add more controls, so it's better to style them in window resources. Textblock will have a centered vertical alignment by default, as well as tiny margins to have some space. After you type it in your resources, you don't have to set it manually on controls.